Hi, this video is about osteoporosis.
In this video, we will explain on description and definition, type, incidence and prevalence, etiology, clinical features, pathophysiology and clinical investigation. Also, the management of prognosis, impairment and functional limitation of osteoporosis.
What is osteoporosis? Osteoporosis is a metabolic disease which depletes bone mineral density or mass, predisposing individuals to fracture. Osteoporosis means porous bone. Normal healthy bone looks like a honeycomb in microscopic view. In osteoporosis, it looks porous. Osteoporosis is an important threat to the health and well-being of our population, in particular the elderly. A reduction in the amount of bone mineral per unit volume of anatomical bone exceeding the natural decline with age. The burden of osteoporosis and its related morbidity and mortality is expected to rise as our population ages. The awareness of osteoporosis and more importantly its related fracture risk among the medical and general public has increased. There are two types of osteoporosis which are primary and secondary. Primary osteoporosis is more common than secondary. The primary osteoporosis, unrelated to other disease, most common in postmenopausal women or older men, can occur at any age, causes by age-related bone loss or idiopathy.
Secondary osteoporosis due to certain behaviors, diseases, or medications, exposure to glucocorticoid medications, hypogonadism, low testosterone, alcohol abuse, smoke, GIT disease, and sedentary lifestyle. The incidence and prevalence of osteoporosis in 2017, the prevalence of osteoporosis in the entire study population was 9.65% for postmenopausal women and 8.08% for elderly males by WHO criteria. Incidence and prevalence in Malaysia 2018. Based on the study of prevalence and the risk factor of osteoporosis among middle-aged and elderly Chinese Malaysian, 15.3% of the overall study population and 32.6% of those aged 71 years and above had osteoporosis.
The prevalence of osteoporosis among women 18.9% was higher than men 11.5%. Overall, 15.3% of the Malaysian Chinese aged 40 years and above from Klang Valley, Malaysia had osteoporosis.
Etiology, it is caused by imbalance between new bone formation and old bone resorption due to lack of calcium, due to lack of hormones such as estrogen in women and androgen in men. Other conditions that cause osteoporosis are Cushing syndrome, thyroid problem, lack of muscle use, bone cancer, and genetic disorders.
Pathophysiology, the factors such as aging, smoking, secondary causes, menopausal, and hormonal, also nutritional and genetic factors, can increase the bone loss. If there is increase in the bone loss, then it can further lower bone density, poor bone quality, and increase the tendency to fall, which will further increase risk of fracture and lead to osteoporosis.
In adults, the daily removal of small amount of bone mineral, a process called resorption, is balanced by an equal deposition of new minerals in order to maintain bone strength. When this balance tips towards excessive resorption, bones weaken and over time can become brittle and prone to fracture osteoporosis. Clinical investigation of osteoporosis. CT scan is used to assess the bone density. Next is bone density test, which is central DSA, gold standard, and screening test.
Hi, we will move to management. The conservative may include education on diet or nutrition, exercise if no fracture to help maintain bone density and reduce the risk of falls, medication to slow bone loss and prevent fractures, and treatment for vertebral fractures. Hormone replacement therapy is beneficial in the prevention and treatment of postmenopausal osteoporosis, while selective estrogen receptor modulators improves and preserves bone density at both the spine and hip. Bisphosphonates are potent inhibitors of bone resorption and calcitonin reduce vertebral fractures and have an analgesic effect for acute pain relief in osteoporosis-related fractures. Vitamin D supplementation in combination with calcium has been shown to reduce fracture in elderly populations with vitamin D deficiency. What about surgery? Kyphoplasty and vertebroplasty surgery used to help decrease pain associated with spinal compression fractures, but both do not improve bone strength or reduce fracture risk, so patients should be given alongside drug treatment. If osteoporosis is detected early and treated, the outcomes are good, Postmenopausal women remain at high risk for hip fracture, which often results in prolonged recovery and nursing home placement. Vertebral fractures are also common and can lead to kyphosis, chronic pain, respiratory compromise, and a high risk to develop pneumonia. The impairment in osteoporosis may include incomplete use of arms or fingers, incomplete use of feet or legs, disfigurement or deformity, and difficulty gripping or holding things. Based on Cooper 1997, about 40% of people are unable to walk independently 1 year after hip fracture, 60% have difficulty with at least one essential activity of daily living, and about 80% are limited in activities such as driving and shopping. People with osteoporosis require significantly more assistance with showering, dressing, eating, toileting, and bladder or bowel control, property maintenance, and healthcare. That's all from us. Thank you.